Let's see what implementing instructive motion might look like. In this example, we have a full bleed image and some content below it. There's a tension here. We want to show the image in full, but we also want to indicate that there's more text available. And perhaps we want to show some of that text content right away too. What we can do is start off with the image fully visible, but then immediately slide up some of the text to indicate there's more content. Let's see how we can implement this pretty simple form of instructive motion. Let's start with the layout. Nothing fancy here, just a frame layout with a fixed height image and a scroll view in front of it. The linear layout in the scroll view will contain our text content and have a white background. We'll give the linear layout a little elevation to make it clear that it's a distinct surface. Now, at the default scroll position, you see the full image but very little text content. All we need to do is animate the scroll position as the screen first opens to a position that shows more of the text content. Here, we're using an object animator to animate the scroll Y property of the scroll view. We could just use the scroll view's smooth scroll to method, but this gives you a bit more control over that animation. We start the animation inside of onEnterAnimationComplete to ensure that the window transition ends first before we start the animation. This is only available in Android 5.0 and later, but you could fake it on earlier versions using something like a start delay. The effect is that you get a quick preview of the image before you start reading about it, and you quickly realize that you could scroll up to see that image in full again, or down to read more.